stepping now to mix with the young DJ Kuda.
Tonight we gonna be going in
on the ones and twos and twos.
Let's get it
on Player Talk Radio.
What is up? What is up? It's DJ Kuda back in the building, man. Let's get to my favorite song, man. Let's get it, man. I know how that shit goes, man. Let's play it to our radio, man. DJ Kuda back at the helm of today's show, man. Let's go. Study 8. This is Study 8. Part 2. Let's go.
To lose my mind.
man, that is my fucking song. That is my goddamn song, man. Play it talk right here, man. That song is needed. That song is needed, man. Chop, not slop, man. That song is needed. God damn. All right. Back into this madness.
Alright. What he didn't know was that I had a similar conversation with her, and she said the same thing to me. So I'm like, oh my goodness.
So this is fiery speaking. This is
timing.
This is the one that's been around for a long time. Let's go.
She was in a relationship at that time, and I didn't really know really what to do, like how to approach it, because me and her had a bond and a trust. But at the same time, we are not higher selves, and we live on truth. We live on truth. So you have to be honest with yourself. Yeah. So I just pretty much told him, and then that's when the doors opened. And then I started communicating with both of them, and they both realized that they had the same thoughts. They were thinking the same thing, and it was time. And I do believe that OMAC knew that it was coming. He knew that it was coming near. And, you know, and I'm so thankful that I could have been a catalyst to bring these two people together, because since they came together in our family, so many things have manifested for us. And I know it's because now we are truly living in truth, and we're not living in the dark, because everybody knew. And everybody that was here and was here prior, they knew what type of relationship OMAC and Eliana had, and the type of energy that Eliana and Master Teacher had. It's just that now that it has come to the light, like, so many things have manifested for our family. You know, the energy has shifted. Like, it's just amazing. And unless you didn't have the experience, I don't expect you to understand, but just place yourself in someone else's shoes and be in a relationship like that, that is detrimental. What would you do? Like, you want to speak about loyalty, but like we said, loyalty has an expiration date. At the end of the day, you got to love yourself first, or nobody else will.
That's fact. You know what I'm saying? That's what it boiled down to.
How are you going to be loyal to something that's destroying you or destructive to your being? You outgrow things. Mm-hmm. It's like people in gangs, right? If you a gang member and you in the Bloods or the Crips, how you going?
So now, like I told you, but I mean, everything comes from the streets. What you can do in corporate America, you can do in the streets. One's just illegal, one is legal. So how things happen in the street, same thing happens in corporate America. You understand what I'm saying? Now, and that's the game right there. Now, the thing is that now he's about to show that he has an understanding of the streets and pimping women and how things go and this, that, and the third. And I was telling you guys, it wasn't coming from nature. It wasn't coming from,
how you gonna be
learning how to properly love a woman and all this other stuff. Because remember, in the beginning, that was my catch. That Nature Boy was doing some simping shit. If you listen to the first show, the Nature Boy show. I'm going to re-put out that show. I'm going to do a player talk flashback and re-put out that show. We didn't even get into the keynote shit. We didn't even get into the reflections from homie to reflection shit. I need to archive these shows too, because a lot of his little followers and shit is over here. But anyway, let's get back into it. And if you believe in this nigga right now, come on, man. That's a new day.
Let's go. To the Bloods and the Crips, once you find out it's on a road to destruction.
Right.
Even though you was committed to that crew at one time, at the end of the day, you outgrow them because you become more conscious and you expand past their consciousness. Yeah. How are you going to still be loyal to something that's going to lead you down to destruction or stunt your growth in life and stunt you from expanding in life? Yeah. How you going to be loyal to that? Loyalty has expiration date, as so should people's marriage certificates.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah, and that's facts, because that's what it all boiled down to. I was like, yo, I asked him, I'm like, how are you growing? And he could not tell me anything. And I was like, my jaw was, I was like, okay, because we're supposed to be on this path of righteousness and studying ourselves. And I was like, yo, this is crazy. So that whole situation just exposed himself and what he got going on with himself. And it also exposed me. So
the fact remains, he did not leave because of what happened between me and you.
He didn't leave because of me and Tahuti.
That's a very important part, because people think that he's sad about it when we already established. Don't know that me, you, him, and everybody sat down and came to that agreement to say that, you know, this is my dream. He's like, yeah, I knew that was your direct the whole time, and so he already agreed. He had found another direct that I just didn't want in my electromagnetic field. He grabbed her too quick. The energy wasn't right. She wasn't on the frequency. And so he decided to leave to go be with her. People don't know that, though.
Yeah.
People think like, oh, you know,
I heard
you, you heard his feelings. Yeah. Well, poor old
he
Mac.
Was actually happy for
us. He was happy for us. Yeah. He was happy for us. He was supportive of it. Mm-hmm. You was there. Everybody was there. He was supportive of it. So, you know what I'm saying? Then he found another direct. And he wanted her to come here. She was like some energy. I was like, nah. I was looking at her Instagram like, she's not on the frequency. You're rushing.
Yeah.
Because
of
the fact that, you know what I'm saying? You just want another direct. But then I felt as well that he couldn't keep, even though we had came to an objective understanding that, you know, we were going to. First of all, people need to understand this. When I first laid eyes on you, I was talking to you first. People don't even understand that, right? Let me push.
I'm not gonna do the Ray J thing again. Sorry.
You can just push it forth.
I'm not gonna do the Ray J.
What people don't understand is this. You can just push it right there. No, push it so everybody. Yeah, there you go, baby. All right. So what people don't understand is this. When I first laid eyes on you, I knew you was my wife, cause I was with Yaya.
Yeah.
And I told Yaya.
Now here's where the shit gets good. Remember we covered the whole Yaya shit. He said the same shit to Yaya. You was my wife. I love you. Yes. Now we're connected. And was doing all of that weird shit, right? And remember I told you. Oh, I'm gonna re-put out the Nature Boy show, man. Let's go.
Go talk to her. Tell her that she's my wife. Yaya didn't talk to you for some reason or something. I don't know, but we got to talk. And I told you, like, yo, you my wife. Your name going to be this, this, and this. I told you all these things on the phone prior to that. Now, you start talking all this crazy shit. I hung up on you.
Yeah.
I hung up on you because you was talking this. You didn't even know what I knew.
Exactly.
So I was just like, you know what? Click. I'm just going to hang up the phone. Now, weeks later, Omek, like, I got a direct. I'm like, all right, cool. If you know Omek has a lot of feminine energy that follows him. A lot of demonic beings are in black women. They like to follow him. They see a weakness in him. And they like that. They like to see, they're like weak men. A lot of feminine energy like a weak man, because a lot of feminine energy in harbors masculine energy. You got women that are Leos, Sagittarius, Aries women. These women are powerful women, and those are the leaders of the community. So the women that you really going to see, like, protecting Omek or some dominant woman. They love Omek.
You have to have the gift of gab. He hustling right now. He's selling water to a whale. He's selling sand to the beach. He's bringing hella sand to the beach. You know what I'm saying? Come on. These Sagittarius, these Leos, these Capricorns with their tropics in the middle of Gemini. You know, they flip back and forth. So when they flip back and forth, then one of the Gemini gonna be bipolar. So that creates a whole new being. And that being's divine. And then that divine, you know what I'm saying? That shit. He hustling. He pimping that Kool-Aid. Come on now.
Back, because Omek comes off subtle and calm. He comes off like really, you know, like online, like, you know, sweet, and they could pick that up.
This is the gift of gab.
So a lot of my exes,
at his finest.
And O-Mac trying to come in the tribe through the back door. And I was like, nah, you can't come here. Like, she can't come here. And I just tell him, I don't care. Anybody that's coming in here, first of all, O-Mac begged me to come here. And so I was like, all right, I gave him the name O-Mac. I gave you the name EJ. I gave you the name Kawadi, or my son named Kawadi. I gave you the name Fury and Willow. I name everybody here and I give them the name because at the end of the day, they're representing extensions of what I teach. You are the extension of what I teach, and everything that I teach comes through you. Yeah. And I speak your heart, and then you speak the knowledge after I give it to you. So therefore, you know,
like, O-Mac, he's a god. Like,
please, you want me a monologue. I want to be there with you. I'm like, all right, cool, dude. You could come here with me. And so when I let people in my circle, you're not just going to bring nobody in my circle that I don't know about. Like, you asked to come into my life. Mm-hmm. I'm not letting anybody and everybody just come into my life. You know what I'm saying? So that's just a controlled environment. That's how I do things. And people just going to have to respect my life and respect how I do things. So if you join me and you a man, and you like, yo, I want to bring this girl along, I'm going to check her energy. If I decide that she can come in, then she can come in. That's just how we roll. Yeah. You understand? That's just culture, tribal shit. People don't understand that because they raised in different kind of Babylon families. They don't understand how that works because their mind is programmed to an abomination. They don't understand that. So, boom. I already told you it was my wife. So Yaya didn't explain it to you, but I had contacted you. And you wasn't ready. Like you said, you wasn't ready. And so anybody that know me know I like, you know what I'm saying, a certain type of woman like I was always attracted to. I was very attracted to you when I seen you. I was like, you were very articulate. I seen your mind was deep and it was open. And I was like, yo, she's beautiful. And she, you know what I'm saying? I just felt something for you when I first saw you. So I was like, yo, tell her to come. Now, you didn't respond to me. I had hung up on you for some reason. That's what I do. Sometimes I talk to people and then I just hang up on them or I ignore the shit out of you. Like, I'll just watch you from a distance. And then I'll see if I want to choose you or, you know what I'm saying? Like, so that's how I treated you. But then you came through the back door to O-Mac. Now, when I seen that you was coming to be O-Mac's direct, I was like, yo, O-Mac, you know I was talking to Shorty, right? He was like, yeah.
Shorty, yeah.
I was like, go ahead, bro. It's all right. You know what I'm saying? So I let you come. I ain't have to let you come, but I let you come. And then when you came, I was like, you sure you want to be with O-Mac? And I said that to you. Yeah. And you was like, yeah, I really like O-Mac. I was like, all right, cool. So you stay your ass over there. Then I tell you, stay your ass over there. And because I already knew you was going to fall in love with me. We was going to fall in love with each other from the beginning. Soon as you got to really know me, see.
And no, Fiery's right here with the biggest smile on her face. And this other girl, she's like leering at him. See, EJ is one of those black girls that got a little Chinese in the face and shit. Little China woman in the face. You see these black girls with the chinky eyes. You ever seen like when your girl gets high sometimes, she look like a little China in the face? Like, oh, you a little China. Look at black China. Don't look shit like a Chinese woman. But I bet you get her high, she around you, her eyes get like chinky. Like a little Pai Young Yao in the face. Little Korea in the face, you know. She leering at you, man. And then the professional side chick, come on. And EJ's like, tell me how you love me, Romeo. Seduce me, Romeo.
They don't know me. Y'all know me. Y'all love me. They don't know me. To them, I come off like a pow. My rising is in Scorpio. So I come off like a dictator, you know, but behind the scenes, y'all know I'm funny as shit. Y'all know I'm sweet. I'm gentle and loving. But they don't know that side of me. They don't know I'm funny as hell. Like, they don't know I'm a goofy nigga. Like, they don't even know that. All they know is that I'm master teacher and da 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 da. And I'm a smart dude or a powerful dude. Whether they like me or not, it's power. You see what I'm saying? So I knew that once you got to see that side of me, because when you see me online, you like, yo, this nigga intense. But once you got to see the real side of me, that you would fall in love with me. You know, anybody is easy to fall in love with me once you know me. And so, that's exactly what happened. Eventually, it just chipped off. But then when she came to me, I was like, the first time when he was like, yo, master teacher, she want to be with you. We had a meeting like that. I was like, I looked at him in his eyes. I was like, bro, I told you we was already. I told you I was in love whenever I first met her. I told you that was my wife, dog. I let you basically smack my wife. I let you smack my wife. I let you be in a relationship with the woman that I told you that I was already in love with when I first met her. I let you do that. So what people don't know is I was letting Omac be with my girl. You feel me? Because I already had I already seen her. I was like, yo, she wasn't ready. But I told Omac before he made that decision. So when it happened, I was like, bruh, I'm telling you, keep her over there. And as she got to know me and, you know, she was like, you know, da da da, and the feelings had seep through. Then the first time when we made that.
Fairy looking at him like, oh, so the truth comes out. The truth comes out. Nature Boy going for broke. Because and I think they fight him too. I think they do on the regular, and then they all start fucking in this weird entendre of sex and mystery. But no, Nature Boy going for broke. So here you have it. It's confusion. I see what's going on. I've been a puppeteer for a good minute. I know what's going on. So what he has is, hold on, let me pause it. He has EJ.
Agreement.
And this is how he can talk like this. Because he gets them pumped up talking about some keep it real. Keep it real. We got to keep it real. Okay, yeah, this is real talk right now. Yeah, we keeping it real. Keeping it real. This is what it really is. So, EJ in the middle, confessing her love. Teaching a new girl the myth, the man, the legend. Making your boy, Nature Boy, be pre-selected, you know, like, this is the guy that I need to be talking to, this is the guy with the bag, this is the guy that calls the shots. Naturally, women are gonna be turned on by that. So, her situation's set up over there. She, you know, your little brain, your bitch chew on that. EJ, new love for me. Like a Nature Boy, like EJ got a new love for me. So, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, she feeling me, so she on her way. Fiery been there for a minute, but she just won't leave, and she's stupid. So, you know, I could lose Fiery and still got two bitches, because, you know, this one, I got to train this new one to be a new EJ, and then I do have an EJ in it. You know what I'm saying? And then Fiery's like, this is what you've been doing. You are too much. You know that? You ever been with somebody that just take you just the way you are, and you know what I'm saying? When you do some stupid shit, you do that little sigh and look in the camera and just be like, You know what I'm saying? You get your way. None of y'all never had your way. Oh, so I'm the only one in here that had his way. Okay. So, Fiery looking at him. You know what I'm saying? He's going for broke. This is something that players do. We do this. We go for broke. You know what I'm saying? Because for real, you know, niggas, your bitch and shit, she bought diamonds for me. How bad do you really like me? Put up with my attitude. How bad do you really like me? Do this for me. You love me? Huh? Kiss me. How bad do you really like me? And then a nigga cheat. How bad do you really like me? So this is what he's doing. He's like, he's out in the open with it. It's like a I'm a real nigga type thing. And who here gonna prove I'm not? So let me let this music play, and let me let y'all do y'all thing. Let's listen to Master Teacher Tahuti.
He brought you to me like, Master Teacher, she wanna be with you. I was like, listen, man, she was always my girl.
Oh, Mac, you better go live, nigga. Get in contact with me, man. I'm not that hard to find.
We knew that. But damn, you played the game because she was pretty, you wanted some pussy, and you wanted to
this
get
nigga's game conscious. Fun. Listen.
Nigga, get out your feelings. Nigga, you already knew. I told you from the beginning. I just let you have my girl. Really on some G shit. So then Omac let her have. I was like, nah, shorty, you got to go back to Omac, because she had a lot of insecurities on at the time. And she had a lot of shit she was going through. I was with Yaya. It was a whole bunch of shit going around. A whole bunch of demons around me. You feel me? So I was just like, nah, shorty, like, it ain't time yet. Like, you not, you know what I'm saying? So I said, go back to Omac. I said, like, go back to Omac. You feel me? I knew that because when we had Made Love that, and I was like, yo, I was like, nah, shorty, like, you belong with Omac. I'm going to let you go. And the reason why we telling you all our business, because people keep assuming what the fuck go back to Omac.
Now, you can tell he capping, because niggas don't be like, we had Made Love that night. Like, if you talk to Omac, like, fellas, how we talk to each other, we talk... You know, you go to your boy. Women talk like this too. Don't get the misconception. You go to your boy and be like, hey, yo, hey, what you do with that little joint last night? Nigga, I punished that joint. Nigga, you know what I'm saying? Ain't no nigga about to look at his man and talk about some, that night we made love. So now Nature Boy, he hustling. He has to use the word love, because then she's like, it wasn't just a fuck. See, bras don't always want to think, oh, it was just a fuck. Nobody wants to be just a fuck. Ain't that fucked up? Oh, it was just a fuck. When niggas get caught cheating, what do they say? Baby, it was just a fuck. It was just a fuck. Or when you deal with a hoe, you tell her to go. It was just a fuck. Nobody, that's the stigma in the dating game. Nobody wants to be just a fuck. So he has to say that around women, because he's not, you know... But it was just a fuck. You think he told Omac they made love? Come on now. Come on now.
Omac.
Come on now.
You feel me? I knew that because when we had Made Love that, and I was like, nah, shorty, like, you belong with Omac. I'm going to let you go. And the reason why we telling you all our business, because people keep assuming what the fuck going on. We want y'all to know what's going on from the horse's mouth. If you're going to be talking about my business, make sure you got that shit right. If you're going to talk about my shit, let me tell you what happened. Don't assume about what happened, because I ain't got nothing to hide. I'm going to tell you the fucking real deal. You feel me? I'm going to tell you, I'm going to lay it all down flat, because I don't give a fuck what none of y'all think about me. But when it start getting in the way of my message, it's a problem. So let me clear some things up. This is why we online right here, to clear some things up for niggas so that they can get a fucking clear perspective. But even then, you can make something so clear for some people, they still can't grasp it. You understand what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, it's like this. Boom. I was like, you go back to him. So she went back to him, but he didn't know we had sex. But we already made the agreement and switched that she was my direct. And I had sex within that time with her. So he didn't know me and her had sex. So when he, maybe weeks later, I guess Yaya left. And Yaya had told her that me and EJ at the time had sex. And I was like, damn, I didn't think that mattered. What y'all didn't know is that this is how I move, bro. And I don't know, real dudes understand this. And let me say this real quick. This is how I move. Look, peep gang. Yo, Nostradamus, you a clown, nigga. I'm blocking you right now, homie. Boom, you blocked, clown. Y'all jealous? Y'all jealous because you can't... Y'all jealous of a... I'm gonna keep going. Boom. So, where I'm from, it's like this. This is how I move. Even when I was in my lower self, I've always attracted a lot of women to me. Like, that's just some dudes got that neck, self. And I'm just one of the dudes that had a neck to attract a lot of women. So, what I realized is this. I never wanted to be with a girl that was looking at another man and wanted to be with another man. This is how I always test my girls. I would take, because I was always with thorough dudes, so I would always hang around thorough dudes, handsome dudes, 6+, tall, dark, handsome, light, handsome, whatever it is. I rolled with a whole bunch of pack of alphas. You understand? So at the end of the day, you know, when I wanted to test a shorty out and see where her mind was at, I would bring her around my dudes. Now, as she was flirty or checking one of my dudes, I knew where to put her at. You understand? So you never want to be with a girl that's not really wanting you. She wanting another man. So at the end of the day, I was big on that. So what y'all didn't know is that Yaya wanted Omac. Real spill. Y'all probably don't know who Yaya is. Ew. Because a lot of y'all following me don't even know the story from the beginning. So it's kind of hard for y'all to catch up. Y'all just hear shit and you like, oh, that's fucked up. You know, you run with it and you like, oh, that's fucked up. So peep game. So I gave Yaya to Omac, because Yaya had a thing for Omac.
He getting Omac back.
And I was like, see, you like, what if Omac did that to you? Bro, I'm a god. I never had that problem in my mind. If a woman want another man, you can't stop her. She gonna always want that man. It's better that you let that woman be who she gonna choose. A woman gonna choose who she wanna be with. This game one-on-one. A woman gonna choose who she wanna be with. See, y'all dudes be trying to make something happen that ain't gonna happen. If you smart and you see a woman already choosing, then you supposed to get out of her way. You supposed to get out of that way. Like, okay, shorty, cool. Like, please, by all means, go over there because I could be with somebody else right now, being with my queen. We wasting time. When you want to be with that man over there, go be with him. So I always let destiny and energy move and choose because that's how it's going to happen anyway. So I was always someone that was lived in the spirit realm anyway, so I could always read body language and move energy and look at energy. I could always see it. So if a shorty was already feeling somebody else, I could be like, when I felt Yaya was feeling Omek, I was like, what I do? I was like, yo, I held the meeting. And I was like, yo, Yaya, you belong to Omek. I gave Yaya to Omek. Facts. Then me and Yaya did a video, right?
And Omek fumbled it and flipped it and tumbled it.
I was like, yo, I held the meeting. And I was like, yo, Yaya, you belong to Omek. I gave Yaya to Omek. Facts. Then me and Yaya did a video, right? And it's blazing in here, yo. Hold on. Then me and Yaya did a video saying that we wasn't compatible and that we are not directs. And then that day, she was going to be going to Omek. And by the end of that video, this chick chooses that she want to be back with me. I was like, wow, really? But she spent the day with Omek. Whether he smashed her that day, I never asked. It don't matter. Once she with you, that's your direct. If it was a goddamn 24 hours and me and you was like, yo, I want, and whatever y'all did is what y'all did. Now, what people don't know is that I gave Kia direct. And I gave Omek Yaya. And then I let Omek have you. Facts. People don't know that, though, because I don't be telling all my business. You just seeing stuff that get exposed. Y'all don't know what's going on behind the scenes or with the details. Y'all really don't understand that. So I'm just going to try to make it a little clear so y'all can understand it. But so Omek already knew. Yeah. I was already talking to Shorty, and then he came in, and she came in, and she started feeling me. So I'm like, yo, bro, listen, man. When she was feeling you, I was all with it. I watched it happen, let it happen. It wasn't fucked up when you did it to me. But I just was being me. I already knew Shorty was my wife. I told Yaya Shorty was my wife. You understand? And you could go confirm that with Yaya if Yaya could tell the truth. Because I told Yaya, like, yo, that's my wife, way before an Omek was around about it. Now, when you chose me, I'm like, okay, cool, that's my woman anyway. I told you that was my woman from the beginning, homie. That wasn't a thing for me. When she came to me, I was like, yo, dog, I let you smash my woman all this time, yo. On some G shit, because she was not ready for me. I actually let you smack her, like, and you was smacking her every night, and you was enjoying that pussy, wasn't you? Now she coming to daddy, she coming home, like, what's good? Run that. On some real shit. That's real shit. So look, a lot of y'all don't know the details, and the devil's is always in the details, so I'm going to give you the details, and y'all can handle that shit and do whatever y'all want with it. But the main reason why we're doing this is to expose truth to what's going on in our life, because we see that it's become a circus, and we want to just let all this shit out and let you know the truth, and so that we can move forward, because the things that we about to do, it's gonna be so powerful. We don't want you to be blocked with stupidity. We don't want you to be blocked with stupidity. We want you to have full understanding and love about what's going on here. Period. Because you're gonna be blocked with stupidity. So a lot of demons has attacked me. I let them attack me. I let them ride. But now I'm in Belize. We doing this shit over. I left and I'm back again. I'm gonna do this shit over again. I give you the most divine wisdom and knowledge of self. And all of these are lessons for us. You don't know the details about something? Shut the fuck up and say I don't know. Be quiet. That's OG classic shit. An OG will tell you, my nigga, if you ain't got all the information about something, shut up. How would you feel if you went in the courtroom and the judge judged you from what the prosecutor said and never heard your side of the story? You can't judge us, you know what I'm saying? It's just, it's too many sides to judge. So the internet give cowards an outlet. Fake niggas can do anything they want on the internet. That's why I really don't be paying these niggas no mind no more. The only reason why I'm on it, like I told you, is because the simple fact is, at the end of the day, I want you, first of all, baby, this ain't about, it's not about them. It's about you getting it off your chest so you can feel comfortable about being on camera with me, about being on camera and not have to feel ashamed because people don't understand what the fuck really happened. It's about you getting it off your chest. It ain't about people saying, oh, you know, it's about her being able to get her side of the story out, wipe your hands with it, and move forward. That's what this is about. Fuck what people gotta say. Ain't nobody ever gonna always 100% agree with you in life. You got to know how to deal with haters. You got to know how to deal with adversities. At the end of the day, most people hate and ain't doing shit with their life. Nigga, you still in Babylon. You still fucked up. And the minute you gonna see us doing what we doing, you gonna be like, damn, this shit crazy. So for me, it's like this, yo. It's what, this where I'ma end it. With what I gotta say. Omek knew that was my girl from the beginning. Put all that he could into her. It did not work. Their relationship was not a healthy relationship. They was always breaking up and fighting. Y'all didn't know that. Because at the end of the day, we was trying to hold something together for y'all. What Melanation was about is about showing black people where we come from, that we can be great. We were slaves. We're descendants of slaves, my nigga. We got a slave mentality. We do not know how to be kings and queens, although we call ourselves kings, queens, gods, and goddesses. We don't know how. We don't know how to be kings. We're slaves. We have slave mentalities. Programs running that we have to come out of. This is why the first time around when I was in Honduras, I had 90 acres of land. Phoenix gave me 30 acres of that land. Number one, my journey took me where I was supposed to be. It is not my will, but God's will. And it's your job in life to submit to God's will. And what happens will happen and is going to happen regardless if you like it or not. So all you can do is submit to what happened and stop complaining about what happened and start rolling with the punches. When things happen in your life, you roll with the punches. You get over them quick and you keep moving. You keep moving. That's what you got to do with life. Now, the reason why I didn't build the first time around in Honduras is because the first crowd of people that came to me was so sick mentally that I would just be recreating Babylon again if I built a society with these people. Mm-hmm. I had the money. The money Babylon was attached right to me. Now. You know why I gave the money away? I gave the money away because it was already written that it's harder for a rich man to get into the kingdom of God as it is a needle through the hole of it. So I had to prove that I was able to overcome money. That's not where my desires and my heart and my treasure was. My treasures have always been in valuing people and getting people to understand knowledge of self. That's all. And in the process of that, I've been tainted because people that look like me hate themselves. And when they look at me psychologically, it has already been proven scientifically that a child at the age of 4 or 5 already hates themselves with a baby doll test. They showed the baby doll test and said, point to the ugly doll. Point to the bad doll. And the black kid always point to the black doll to be ugly or bad, which means psychologically, there's programs running that has been in our genetics for years that are slave mentalities that make us self-hate each other. We just hate each other. Let me tell you something. The reason why people say they want to expose me is because they already seen something was powerful there. If I wanted to expose somebody, I had to at first acknowledge that there was something powerful there first. Now I'm going to seek to destroy it by going to expose it. Because this person is being too powerful and being too great. Oh my God, let's expose Nature Boy. To even say that you want to expose me is to acknowledge my power to first to be with. So you expose somebody, you have to look at them like, oh, he's doing something great, but this ain't what he really about. Do you know what I had to do to make our people depict or look like something that they wasn't in real life. We were so fucked up and discombobulated, unorganized, unstructured. People was coming with all kind of sick remedies and understanding. I had to lay law. So my first year, I was just laying law. People was hating me. They was leaving. They was like, fuck that dude. Because I was laying law of knowledge of self. And we had rules and regulations that we have to live by and find our mind again. And it was like, fuck rules. They was acting like Moses' people. After Moses freed the people, he went back to get the law.
This nigga,
when he went back to get the law in nature
himself
from that burning bush, he came back and the people was a godless people. So what happens is when you take people to the jungle, right, God, the laws of nature.
Let me stop. Let's get into the mix, man. Shout outs to my baby, Anne-Marie. This Nature Boy shit is stupid. It's stupid. So let's get into let's get into the mix. And then we're going to get into today's show topic. We're going to play Ways Women Manipulate Men by Diana Davidson. Okay? All right. So, let's take the tone of today's show down a bit. Let's get smooth and sensual and all that mushy shit. And let's get into today's mix. And then we're going to get to today's game. Because that's what we're here for, man. We're here to learn and to get game. So let's get it. All right?
Now you know you got to break the game down a little bit more. Because they might be slow.
Let's go. Shout outs to EJ's newfound love. Master teacher to Hootie.
Every day a little more. Oh, each other's
love, bitch.
What we waiting for? Sleep whenever I lie down to sleep. I lie down to sleep. Also swimming constantly. And I can't deny the love for you I feel. And whenever I tell you I gotta go, a heart starts to feel the pain. Wondering when will I see you again. I can't pretend I'm feeling like I'm letting you love me.
Let's get it.
Radio.
Spend when you want my mind. Hard to be afraid. And whenever I tell you I gotta go, my heart starts to feel the pain. And I wonder when will I need to see you again.
Show you all the love that I'm feeling.
because they might be slow. give me one good reason. Stay away, stay away. No. Oh, no, 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 no.
Today's show, man. We are in the mix, man. DJ Cooler, let's get it, man. Play it on radio.
So many things I'm going through. So much that I want to do. Starting to become so plain to me. Tomorrow ain't really guaranteed. So many days I thought of you. It's about to be through the truth. Got to act quickly, you and I. So many reasons why. Now I feel for you. Why? I'm to swallow each and every ounce of my pride. Everything you do, I wanna feel again. Ain't no use for us to pretend.
Let's get it. It's Player Talk Radio. It's my favorite song from A. Marie. This is one of the saddest songs I've ever heard. Like, this song makes me feel sad for no fucking reason. It's just a beautiful song, man. It's Player Talk Radio, man. If you got any questions, email me at playertalk8@gmail.com. It's a real sad breakup song, man. Listen to this shit, man. Play It Talk Radio, man. All right. We are in the building. We are doing this shit today, man. All right. Scroll over. Got this shit going on, man. Let's play a talk radio. That whole Nature Boy shit, man. So one of them is pregnant, man. Or two of them may be pregnant. Could be Nature Boys. Could be Omex. Never know. Omex could have got EJ pregnant and rolled out. You know? So. Nature Boy got a circus going on over there, huh? You guys been following on the show. I like doing shows like this. It's a pretty good show. Once again, go over to the Black Ink Think Tank, man. I'll be in this comment section. Couching it up. Couch gang for life. You know what I'm saying? Tank gang for life, you know? If you ain't in on those conversations, man, you're lost in the sauce. Like dual exhausts. Alright, man. Let's get into exposing how women manipulate men. And I like hold on, let me do this again. Yeah, here we go. So, and I like her. Little goth girl. Goth girls are cool. They know a lot. A lot of them do get on that feminist shit. But a lot of them do have logic. And she's one of them. Okay? So she's gonna talk about, she talks about feminism too and shit. She's pretty good. Fucks with this. Listen to this. Alright.
Hi, I'm Diana Davison. And Diana I've Davis. Been talking about the behavior of women and men's rights issues, etc., for a fair amount of time, and I'm continually asked if I can come up with a list that explains female behavior and how they manipulate men. This is extremely difficult to do because women are information gatherers. That's their currency, that is power to them. And the first thing that women do with men is to study them and to figure out how to manipulate them. Specifically, it's always catered to the individual that they're targeting. So you can't just come up with a generic list. What I've come across recently, a show called Snapped, introduced me to some specific cases of women who've been busted, either trying to kill their husband or having successfully killed them. And I liked this series because they have courtroom footage and interrogation footage of the women, which allows us to observe their behavior. I'm going to take one specific and rather stunning case of a woman called Dahlia DiPolito. And this was a highly publicized case because the sting operation that caught her was dramatically played out. They didn't just catch her soliciting an assassin, they went through the entire scenario with their undercover cop and then setting up a crime scene, calling her to the crime scene, telling her that her husband was dead, and then recording all of this footage.
The car wired for video and audio.
Hey.
Hey.
We're staying in
Paris.
And then interrogating her, pretending that they were, you know, felt really bad for her, and they just wanted information to try and figure out who might have done this. And then revealing to her on camera,
study eight,
in the interrogation room, that they had caught her on tape hiring the assassin, and the game was up, and her husband was still alive. They brought him to the door of the room that she was in, and her reaction to seeing him actually alive, all of this sinking in live time.
Oh my God.
He's alive.
Come here, please. Come here. Mike, come here. Come here.
So here they have her in the interrogation room, and she has this whole play games. This is how she manipulates. She's like, oh my God, come here. Come here, fellas. Come here is a direct command. We talk about the psychology. When she says come here, that's a direct command, and it's in a babying voice. Whether, unbeknownst to you, nigga, You've been hearing "come here" in a baby voice since you could remember shit as a baby. And it's real emotional to look at your girl and just try to get your ass killed. Do this. Now, this is you can't weave yourself out of this situation. You can't snake yourself out of this situation. So what happens is this puts her in a situation to be the real person she is. But what you guys got to understand is that women have arrogance and entitlement on them. So they don't know how to negotiate themselves out of situation without expressing this entitlement and arrogance. So what's going to happen is she's going to keep giving them these direct commands. And let's see what happens. But the thing is, they try to get you close to them. You do not want to get close to them. Because that's, as masters of the physical realm, fellas, you do not want to get close to them. Let's go.
I'll link to all the footage below, and I'll link to coverage of the cases below. I'm not going to go through the footage.
Alright, so listen. This is going to be a part 3. Catch me on part 3. Alright. So, my bad, because we're running a little bit on time today. I'm kicking it with you guys a little bit later than I should be. There's going to be a part 3. So catch me on part 3. So it's Player Talk Radio. We about to get out of the building for a slight second, and then we're going to start part 3. Shout outs to the Rebound. And shout outs to the After the Party. That's my guy. That's my guy. That's my guy. All right, so we're going to do part 3. Clap it up if you stuck around. We're going to go into how women manipulate you on part 3. You know what I'm saying? So, let's get it, man. If you're not gonna manipulate me, well, I ain't gonna say shit. Let's get it. Come on, let's go. The Rebound, man. Let's get it. It's Player Talk Radio, man. We are in the building, man. Let's go. Let's get it.
Tell you that you always been right, but baby, I got news for you.